Welcome back. My name is Mike, and this is Ranking Recent Watches. That's right. It's the only video on the internet where I rank 10 films that I've recently watched, and I put them in order going from my least favorite to my favorite, and I also hurt some feelings along the way with my awful opinions. And in this video, I'm going to be ranking Let the Right One In, Haunt, Hellfest, The Watchers, VHS, Piranha 3DD, Love Lies Bleeding, The Beekeeper, Doom, and The Haunting. So without further ado, let's get into episode 2 of Ranking Recent Watches. So, number 10, I would say, let's put... What was terrible? Oh, the fucking The Watchers. Okay, easy. Number 10, The Watchers. What are the positives? Well, I think that the color grading was nice. I like that. But there were other things that I saw, like, the rest of the movie that I... that weren't as good.
Fairies, nope. That's all I wrote.
Okay, listen, alright? The Haunting should have been number one. Owen Wilson says wow in it multiple times.
Wow. Wow, you're so dominant.
Wow. Wow, I sort of got screwed on the old bedroom selection.
However, The Haunting's gotta go at number 9. I'm sorry, it was just, I was so disappointed. I was so frustrated. And I'm really disappointed that I have to put it this low, but I really do have to put it this low. There was so much potential. There was so much potential going on. It was like, damn, we got a nice cast, a star-studded cast. Lily Taylor gives a great performance, I think. All the acting was pretty solid. And the best part of the movie, the best part in my opinion, the set. The set design, the mansion that they're in, they built it up so perfect. And then there was just a bunch of CGI that made it look like dumb garbage. And I understand that there's like dated CGI, and that's okay. That's all right. I get it. Listen, you got to start somewhere. I get it. Look at my YouTube channel, okay? I get it. But like, dude, come on. Just less is more. Show less. You had the house. You had the cast. You had the acting chops. You had an interesting premise. I was so ready for this to be like number one or two or three, and it just kept getting lower and lower, and it just was fucking blah, dude. Fun side note about this film, I noticed upon viewing that Liam Neeson and Owen Wilson kind of have the same nose.
Wow.
Alright. I'm ranking this at number 8, and people might not like this, but I'm putting Hellfest at number 8, because quite frankly, Hellfest does everything that another movie does on this ranking a lot less good. Believe it or not, English is my first language. Hellfest just felt like a good movie to throw on at a Halloween party, because you kind of don't have to pay attention too much, but I just personally didn't connect with it that much, because I watched it after watching another movie on this. I'm just gonna say Haunt. You already know what it is, probably. Haunt. I watched Haunt, and then I watched Hellfest, and dude, Haunt was so much better. It did everything so much better, in my opinion. Well, actually, that's not true. Hellfest does do some things a lot better than Haunt. For example, I will say, if you're used to going to theme parks and stuff like that during the spooky season, well, Hellfest is gonna be a lot closer to that, whereas Haunt is like this weird deranged shipping container that they all kind of hang out in, is what it feels like. The characters of Hellfest were kind of annoying for me. I felt that the writing wasn't nearly as good as Haunt, and it kind of felt a little cringy. On a positive note, I do think that Hellfest did a great job of incorporating the atmosphere of one of those Fright Fest type experiences. Like, they utilize certain things in the amusement park, and just that kind of sense that, hey, we're in public and we're around people, but we're still not safe, which makes it even creepier. It just really did a great job of incorporating a Fright Fest type event into a horror film. Okay, I'm gonna put VHS next. You know what? I'm gonna put VHS at number 7. Yeah, don't want to spoil too much. There's a decent amount of plot twists. It's surprisingly watchable for found footage. And if you haven't seen it, check it out. VHS. There's a handful of them. I've only seen this one. And I've heard VHS 2 and the other ones are some of the better ones. I heard VHS 2 is really good. That's like one of the better ones. I'm looking forward to that. But yeah, really excited to check out the rest of the VHS movies. It's a great movie. I really enjoyed it, and I was tempted to put it two films higher on the list. At number six, I'm going to put The Beekeeper. I'm putting The Beekeeper at six because it's really entertaining. It is really entertaining, but it's also really dumb, and I think they know it's dumb. Part of me feels like this whole movie was kind of a joke. It's like they took John Wick, but they're like, what if we just do that with like an old lady getting a scam call? And they're like, perfect, ship it. It doesn't matter. All we have to do is make sure that the introduction credits sequence is absolutely gorgeous, and people will just be on board from there. And I was. I legitimately was, and it was fun. And I know it's dumb and it's stupid, but I honestly kind of don't care because it's like well shot. It's like such a stupid, goofy movie. It's like a B movie plot.
You like jazz?
So anyway, it's like a B movie plot, but like there's a lot of production value and stars behind it, and I'm like, what? What is this? What is this? It's oddly entertaining, even though I feel like it's pure schlock. Don't believe me? Check out this awesome scene where Jason Statham elbows a guy so hard that his helmet doesn't even matter. How does he get that much momentum on a downward elbow on a standing opponent that's wearing a helmet? I don't know, but this movie doesn't need you to ask those questions. Just shut up. Look at the credit sequence. It's so impressive that not only did we put it in the beginning of the film, we also managed to squeeze some of it into the trailer. That's incredible. So yeah, The Beekeeper. I feel like VHS should be higher than The Beekeeper, but honestly, The Beekeeper just is so much easier to watch. It's just dumb and digestible, and I'm okay with that. You know what? I'm okay with that. Sometimes that's what you need. Sometimes you need a Godzilla versus Kong in your life just to I don't know. I really don't know. Damage your brain? I don't know. At number five, I'm going to put Doom. And this is where people are going to click off the video. This is where my watch time is going to take a nosedive. Doom is a guilty pleasure. Listen, it's not a great movie, even though I like it probably more than I should. It's just all right. It's not even all right. It kind of sucks, but I enjoy it. I enjoy it. It's fun, and the monster design is good, and I like to see Carl Urban and Richard Brake. I enjoy seeing them, and it's even interesting to see The Rock in his earlier days. I like to see some of the futuristic technology, like these doors that you can walk through, and then you push a button, and then they solidify. I feel like that was interesting, but most of all, I found the film rather just boring, and it's kind of just a guilty pleasure because I know the video game and I like some of the actors in it. It's not great. The only thing that people remember from this film, like the only thing that people will remember from this film, is when The Rock says "Semper Fi, motherfucker," and it's like, "Oh shit, that's cool.
Semper Fi, motherfucker."
Okay, I can't in good conscience put Doom this high on the list, so I'm moving it down. This is the new ranking, calling an audible mid-video. I know, crazy. Back to the video. All right, ranked at number four, I'm going to put Piranha 3DD or 3DD, whatever you want to call it. I got to say, Piranha 3DD is so stupid, but it's so funny. It's so funny. I had a good time. It's that funny where you're laughing at how dumb it is. The movie doesn't take itself seriously, and you kind of know that just from reading the title, but I still found it to be a rather enjoyable summer horror movie. It's not too schlocky for me, even though I could see some people saying, "What the hell am I watching?" But I had fun with it. I don't care. And I was surprised to see some people in this. Like, I hadn't seen Danielle Panabaker in a lot of stuff recently, and I was like, why isn't she in more stuff? She was great in the Friday the 13th remake. And then I saw this, and I was like, maybe this was like one of the nails in her career's coffin or something. I don't know, maybe. But I was surprised to see some people in this where I'm like, that's a real actor. And they're in Piranha 3DD. Shocking. There really isn't too much to say about it because, I mean, it wears its premise and its goofiness on its sleeve. But if you like boobies and goofy, ridiculous comedy horror movies that are based around piranhas, then this is the movie. This is definitely one of the movies of all time, for sure.
Wow.
All right, ranked at number three, I have Haunt. And I gotta say, Haunt, really, I had a lot of anticipation going into it because I've seen the cover everywhere. You know, as a horror fan, you see the cover all over the place. You see those masks and you're like, I wanna watch this. I wanna watch this. Those masks really stick out. And I gotta say, when I finally watched this movie, it absolutely Fallout Boyed me because I got way more than I bargained for. And that main final girl, the protagonist, ooh, Sugar went down swinging. I mean, that ending with the... Oh, someone stopped me. I'm peaking my audio. Woo! That shit gets me hyped, dude. Hyped. Hellfest wanted the punch. Like, when Hellfest had their ending, they thought that it was gonna have the punch that Haunt did, but it didn't. But Haunt, that ending slaps, dude. But yes, Haunt was awesome, it was fun, it was a horror movie that was based around a haunt, if you will. It's based on around a couple of people going to this extreme haunted house, and it is quite extreme. And the characters that are in it are really interesting and unique. All of the different masked people that are at the haunted house are really interesting, and I don't want to get too much into it, but all of their unique designs are awesome. They stood out and it hit. Can I put two movies at first place? This is my own channel. Am I allowed to do that here? Can we do that? We can? We can't. Okay, we can't. They would be mad. Okay. I'm being told by no one in the corner that we can't do that, actually. So, all right, at number two, I'm going to put Love Lies Bleeding. It's really difficult to rank these two, but Love Lies Bleeding is going to go at number two, and I don't have anything bad to say about this film. I have nothing bad to say about this film. I loved everything about it, really. I can't think of anything off the top of my head that I didn't enjoy. And this movie has solidified Rose Glass as one of my favorite directors working today. I think she killed it with Saint Maud, and now, again, writing and directing this film. Now, there was another writer on this one, but writing and directing again, and she just crushed it. She knocked it out of the park. It looks great. I love everything. Like, honestly, I'm stoked to see what Rose Glass does next. I want to see what she does next, because this was dope. It was awesome. I had a blast watching this. It picks up and it doesn't let go. I feel like the pacing is great. So yeah, Love Lies Bleeding. Acting good, casting good, story's good, directing's good, cinematography's good. It was just all around a solid, solid film. I enjoyed it. And if you haven't seen it, Love Lies Bleeding, I definitely would say it's worth a watch. And then ranked at number one, I have Let the Right One In. This is a classic vampire film that many people will list on their favorite horror movies of all time. I finally watched it, and I gotta say, it's solid. It's great. The ending is great. The way that it tells the story is great. The way it kind of builds this relationship between the two of them. You see that they're making sacrifices and changing based on the other person just to... You see that they're good for each other, you know what I mean? The two protagonists are outcasts and they're very sympathetic, and while there are horrific sequences, and I guess this is kind of classified as like a horror movie, it's more about this quiet relationship between these two outcasts and how they actually kind of benefit each other. You get to see them making sacrifices, changing, different things that show that they really care about each other, and it's nice to see that they have someone to lean on, because otherwise, they're basically alone. In my opinion, Let the Right One In is one of the best vampire movies ever made, and I think if you have not seen it yet, you definitely should. Thank you for watching my video all the way through. I really do appreciate it. Maybe consider liking and subscribing if you want to see more stuff like this. If any of these movies you want me to make a detailed video on, maybe leave a comment and I'll consider getting to it. So yeah, that's it. Thanks so much. Love you. I'll see you in the next video. Peace.
Wow.